The Association of Southeast Asian Nations, or ASEAN, has granted Britain dialogue partner status, giving it high-level access to the regional bloc summits. Britain has been seeking the status to build stronger diplomatic ties in Asia following its exit from the European Union last year. The UK 2 months ago sent out warships in the region as part of its plan to step up its engagement with Asia. The 26,000-mile mission includes naval exercises with the US, Australia, France, and Japan in the Philippine Sea. It also plans to permanently deploy 2 warships in Asian waters as it expressed growing alarm over China's territorial ambitions in the region. China, for its part, warns foreign Navy vessels to abide by international law when sailing across the South China Sea.
Still with the U.S., President Joe Biden is reportedly planning to overhaul country's policy in arms exports, giving more weight to human rights concerns. Sources say the administration has already briefed a small group of congressional aides 2 weeks ago, outlining the State Department's desire for a more robust review of weapon sales by getting more inputs from the Human Rights Bureau. The formal unveiling of the plan is expected as soon as next month. Biden's predecessor, Donald Trump, revamped the conventional arms transfer in 2018, giving commercial concerns as much weight as human rights in deciding whether to approve weapon sales. Biden's possible shift may affect its military support to countries like the Philippines, which has seen many human rights violations under the Duterte administration.
The World Health Organization is calling for a moratorium on COVID-19 booster shots, at least until the end of September. The WHO says this is to ensure there is enough supply of vaccines going to 4 countries. It wants at least 10% of the population of every country vaccinated before talks of booster shots.
So far, more than 4 billion vaccine doses have been administered globally. More than 80% have gone to high and upper middle income countries, even though they account for less than half of the world's population. I understand the concern of all governments to protect their people from the Delta variant. But we cannot and we should not accept countries that have already used most of the global supply of vaccines, using even more of it, while the world's most vulnerable people remain unprotected.
But the call seems to have fallen on deaf ears. The United States says it has enough vaccine supply to share with the world, even while providing booster shots to its population.
Funds in the nation. And well, Jeff, we feel that it's a false choice and that we can do both. So we've taken action on the global level far more than any country around the world. We're asking the global community to also step up. We saw some action at the G7. More needs to happen. But we believe we can do both. We will have enough supply to ensure if the FDA decides that boosters are recommended for a portion of the population to provide those as well. We believe we can do both and we don't need to make that choice.
The U.S. last month signed a deal with Pfizer-BioNTech to buy 200 million additional doses to help with pediatric vaccinations and possible booster shots. Israel, meanwhile, has kicked off a campaign to give booster doses to people aged over 60.
In business, casino stocks fell on Wednesday as the gambling hub of Macau began testing hundreds of thousands of people for COVID-19 after it recorded new COVID-19 cases. Some entertainment venues were also shut down. The resurgence of cases there has cast a shadow over the fate of casinos, Macau's main economic engine. Wynn Macau plunged to its lowest since March 2016 over fears they may have to close if the spread of the virus is not contained. Macau has registered only 59 COVID-19 cases and no deaths so far, according to data from Hong Kong government.